Black touches yellow, it kills a fellow.
Are you kidding me?
Oh!
He got you!
Is that a long nose or is that a spotted gar?
Nah, I ain't grabbing it.
What? A little update on the bucket. We're almost there. We're like 60% there, y'all.
I'm gonna try to get those gar out of there. I'm gonna take the boots off.
See if I can get to them without busting my butt.
Alright, so this is what we're doing. We're trying to go to the Glades, but we gotta stop and get some food real quick at BK. We got Mr. 305, the guy, trying to figure out what's taking us so long trying to get our food, y'all. We've been literally sitting here for how long, Bryce?
Freaking at least 30 minutes, man.
At least 30 minutes in the same exact
fast food.
For real.
Fast food's supposed to be fast.
Pedro's mind is just blown right now. He has no idea how to comprehend this, so he's got to go there and try to see what's going on.
Oh, we've been for like 40 minutes, bro. God.
Well, hopefully we get our food soon and we can go to the Glades. Not really expecting too much, but anything that we encounter is going to be a blessing. So I hope you are ready for today's video. Like, comment, and subscribe if you're new. Oh, man. Bro, what on earth? BK credit card? BK's running out of money? Jeez, that's what it looks like, y'all. They're short-handed. It's all good. Bro. Alright, y'all. So, a little update. We did get our food. We're over here. We're just flashlighting around in the Glades. Oh, you got one. What do you got?
A snake.
Where's the snake at?
He's right here, bro.
You caught him?
Yeah, right here, bro.
Where is he?
Right here, bro. Yeah.
Where?
Right in that corner right there. You see his body? On the root.
Where?
Wait, that looks... That doesn't look like a python, though, right?
No, that's the brown water snake.
Where is he? I don't see him.
I see him, bro.
Look, it's right there?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
If you want, go step right there and look over here. You see him better there, the tail and all that?
Oh, yeah. Look at that. He's right there. Bryce, this might be your moment, dude.
Dude, no, this is not my moment.
Yeah, it is, dude.
I'm going to come on your side.
Yeah, I think that'd be...
Bro, he's going to run towards me.
Grab him by the head or grab him by...
I'm telling you, grab him.
By the head?
Yes. He doesn't have fangs. Just grab him. Hard.
Got him.
Okay.
Oh, he's chill.
I told you.
Oh, he's my chill. God.
He's so chill.
I told you, dude.
He's so chill. He's not... Look, he's... Oh, there he is. Now he's starting to wake up. This right here, guys, brown water snake, completely harmless. Out here eating fish. He's probably hunting for a frog or something like that, right?
Always.
I'm feeling his body right now. It's really, really warm. So he's out. He's, I don't know what he's doing, but I'm guessing he's hunting because this is a nocturnal species out here in the Glades. Wow, look at the beautiful.
He probably just shedded. That's, yeah, he just shedded.
He's like, it's like diamonds.
Holographic.
Yeah, that's dude.
Crazy.
Crazy iridescent flare going along his scales right there. What an absolute beauty. It's my first ever water snake by myself. Now he's starting to clinch a little bit. He's starting to musk me. All right, it's all right. Now he's starting to realize that I am somewhat of a threat. Just chill. Anyways, we just wanted to get him up close and personal for the camera for you guys, but I think it's time that we send this beauty back where she belongs, into the lagoon. Gorgeous specimen. Okay, we're gonna release the head first and just put her right here and let her just go on her way. On the count of three. 1, 2, 3.
Oh no.
Go ahead, sweetheart. Go back into your nest.
Oh, look.
Oh,
look.
Oh,
look.
Oh, she.
Oh, oh. I wanted to see that.
Her climb the tree.
Let her go.
Oh, look. That's what I
Cottonmouth.
Get him, Tara. Get him.
Nice.
Hurt him.
Yeah. Yes, hello. Oh,
I was
brown.
Ooh. They have the derpiest freaking faces.
That's a baby anaconda. Look at that.
That's a daggum baby. Look at that earthworm on that board.
Look at that. That's probably what he was probably trying to hunt.
Predators to think that they're a venomous species. And so they have a very, very similar pattern. You pretty much have to look at the head. The head, the patterns on the head The shape of the head is not reliable because when they get scared, they can actually flatten their heads out to make it look like a triangle. And that's why a lot of people kill the banded water snakes, because they flatten their heads to make themselves look bigger and look venomous, when they're just flattening their heads out to make themselves do that, and they're not actually a venomous species.
Oh!
He got you!
Yeah, this is a Florida green water snake.
That's a different species, huh?
Yeah.
Where was that one at?
He was just hanging out. He's about to cross the road, actually. He is biting the living
crap
out of me, dude.
Rub his nose. Let him go. I'll let go.
Holy smokes, dude.
He's getting you.
It's crazy. Do you need a stick or something to get him off?
I'll let go in a second. He's really hanging on.
Oh. Just calm down, buddy.
Push him into it. Dang, he's getting you good. There, ow, he got me now.
There he is.
Oh
my gosh.
All right. So we got two of our native, these are actually native snakes. These are supposed to be here. So we've got the Florida green water snake, and we've got a brown water snake.
Brown water snake, right? Guys, this is why you guys don't want to be handling snakes if you guys aren't experienced, especially if you guys don't know what species it is. It could be venomous. In this case, it's not. They're non-venomous. They just have really sharp teeth, and they also have anticoagulants in their saliva as well, right?
Yeah, so that looks way worse than it actually is.
It's just like a little pinprick. Like, it's like their teeth are smaller than the needles you use to prick your finger to check your blood sugar.
This is probably as bad as, like,
you
ever had a cat on
bite.
Your... Yeah, I've never had a bite this bad, actually. This is about as bad as, like, if you had a cat on your lap and it scratched you because it got scared. That's pretty much what just happened here, but...
Since it has the anticoagulants, right?
Yeah, I'm bleeding like a stuck pig.
I'm gonna send these guys on their way so they can go eat some more fish, eat some invasive fish out here. Go on, bud. There he goes. There goes that one.
Damn. Really, no lacerations. It's just like.
Yeah. Look at all those little pen bites right there, though. Mm-hmm. You see that right there? Those are just, I guess,
he's probably just the teeth.
He's got several little teeth in there, and I guess that's what he uses to, like, grasp fish and mm-hmm. other amphibians, frogs, small mammals, whatever he can get his mouth on. There Check that out right there. Dude, that's at least, like, what, like 20 teeth bites right there?
Yeah.
Teeth marks?
Yeah, I mean.
Yeah.
Got
some white.
Yoink.
What is that?
Yes, that is, in fact, an Oscar. Now, I want you guys to take a wild guess how these fish got in the Florida Everglades. Go for it, guys.
They probably got out of people's aquariums, or like they have them as fish.
Big.
Got too big for their aquarium, I guess.
So, escaped an aquarium, got too big. Both of you guys are right. These fish are very popular in the pet trade, as we know. They go for a lot of money in the pet shop. That fish in a pet shop is probably like a $20 to $30 fish.
Easy.
What?
People get them. They get aggressive. They can't feed them. They get big, and guess what?
They end up in the Everglades.
Is a water boatman, aka a tow biter. And apparently what it does with the fish, it'll grab onto the fish, give it a nice little bite, and inject a flesh dissolving enzyme, which basically immobilizes and breaks down the fish so he can go ahead and slurp it up. Looks crazy, looks like a water roach.
Like 2-3 times that size.
Crazy, it looks like a palmetto roach, but it's a water version.
Palmetto
roach. It's like an evil.
That's 7 foot.
Yeah, that's a chunky boy. He is unbothered.
Snake! Snake, snake, snake! Your first snake, dude.
Nah.
It's a baby, it's a baby.
Nah.
Look.
Dude, you gotta grab that.
Nah, I ain't grabbing it.
What? He's a baby, he's a baby. Bro, you gotta face your fears, bro. Wait, hold on, no, don't touch. Oh. Go ahead, Bryce. He's not caught yet, dude.
Oh my gosh.
Dude, that's me. Just grab him softly.
By the head?
No, just pick him up.
Just pick him up. He's real gentle. He's tiny. He's a newborn.
Oh, it feels like a worm.
He's wet. Just grab him. Just grab him.
I got you.
Just put him in your hand, dude. Oh. Yes.
Oh!
Oh! Yes.
shoot.
You did it, bro. Congrats.
Good eye, though, bro.
Here, here.
No, no, no. Grab him. Grab him.
I've had my fun.
There you go. You catch him,
bro. Thank you, man.
Yeah.
And Pedro said he might be a newborn, right, Pedro?
Yeah. Super.
Wow, look how small he is. That is so cute.
I don't think he might be a garter snake.
No?
No.
That's what I'm saying.
Okay, maybe he's not a garter snake, guys. So I don't know what kind of snake this is. Drop a comment. Let us know. It could be a brown snake, a garter snake.
A cotton brown
snake. Yep. No, could be anything. But my guess, he's over here eating flies. There's hundreds of them out here. So we'll just put him back where we found him. Go ahead, buddy. Be free in the wild.
Think I can just grab him?
I don't know. We do got a net. You want a net?
Yeah. I think that would be easy.
Yeah, just net some.
Oh my gosh. Those are the lobster?
Yep, lobster fish.
Lobster
right here.
Fish, guys. I'm going to grab the net. Is it in the car?
Yeah, it's in the back. Check it out, y'all. So what's going on? It's the wet season. You guys can see this levee right here is pumping tons of water every second. Look at that right there. And these guys are right here just holding on for dear life. There could be more. Oh my gosh, there's, yep, they're in there as well, guys. So we'll be back. We're gonna see if we can get a net, put them in the bag.
Oh, got him.
Got him.
Got him.
In the bag. This is the fish we're talking about, guys. The Cascadoo, as known as the brown hopolo, invasive catfish out here in the glades. We're gonna catch as many as we can, fill in this bucket, hopefully do a catch, clean, and cook on this right here, guys. In South American countries, in Trinidad and Tobago, this is considered the lobster fish. Got two, whole bucket full, more to go. In the bag.
Thank you.
One, two.
Oh, got something. Got three of them.
Fatty.
Yeah, he just farted. Did that
you're getting him. That's a big one, bro. PB right there, bro. For the night.
Where are you going, Rocket? Rocket! He went around, dude. He drifted. He drifted.
Holy smokes. Dude, you got a lot, bro.
Is that a long nose or is that a spotted gar? Just analyzing.
Watch out. I just got semi-spiked by.
Oh, I lost something big, bro.
What do you mean?
I lost something big, bro.
Why, you made a hole in it?
No.
You felt it?
Yes, bro.
Holy smokes.
That's why I just reeled it up, like, you know, picked it up quick. Oh my god.
Probably had a giant one, bro.
I guess they could be passing at any moment here with the water going this fast.
Yep. In the bag.
In the bag.
Bucket. Just a little update on the bucket. We're almost there. We're like 60% there, y'all. 60%. If we can fill this whole entire bucket up, we are going to do a catch, clean, and cook on this catfish right here, y'all. I don't think there's any video for documented on doing a catch and cook on this invasive catfish, so you guys are going to see it right here on the Iguana Man. Stay tuned. Huge shout out to the Big Cheese coming out here.
Yes, sir.
Lending a helping hand. Also, he's going to be doing a different recipes of this catfish. If you guys want to see that video, make sure and go check him out. We're going to put the link right there.
Yes, sir.
Along with that handshake right here. Bum, bum, bum. Also in the description down below. But dude, talk about a pretty good night of fishing so far, right?
Dude, do these really taste like lobster? That's what I'm super curious. They're an invasive species, but yet they're going to be so delicious.
That is what we're going to have to wait and find out. Do they really taste like lobster? Oh, man. You know what's funny, bro? You said you wanted to catch something bigger like a minute ago, bro.
Seriously.
And there you have it, bro.
Speak it into existence.
Absolutely. You guys are seeing living proof of it right there. Any eggs?
No, bro.
No caviar for us? All right, that's the perfect eater right there, bro.
That's the eater right there.
That's a perfect eater right there. Not too big. Oh, no! No! No!
No! No! No!
Hey, dude, get him in the bag, bro.
You ain't going nowhere.
Oh, nice, bro. That's a good way to finish it off, bro. Fill the bucket up right there.
Yes, sir.
What did you catch now, bro?
Bro, this is actually a spotted gar. It's funny, Iguana Man was making a point that all these fish out here, they have armor on them to protect them.
Mm-hmm.
So it's pretty cool.
The catfish, the gar, the gators, the snakes even.
Yep.
Seems like everything is fully equipped with a nice set of armor. Luckily for this guy, though, you're going to send him back on his way?
Yeah, we don't really want to fool with this one. He's such a beautiful creature. We're going to go ahead and throw him back.
All right. Fair enough.
He's a native species. Look at him go.
Whoa, whoa, he's going.
Oh, hey.
Oh, no.
Hey. Oh. Got a second wind there.
Oh, wow. Back in the current. He zipped off.
Real quick, just want to show you guys how thick and healthy the ecosystem is over here on the Everglades. You guys are seeing it right here. Thousands of mayflies. All that is going to offer food for all the animals going up the food chain. We got some more right there. They are literally everywhere. So it all starts with this. Everything gets to eat, all the way from the small lizards, frogs, snakes, all the way up to the big gators, the turtles, and of course the invasive Burmese pythons.
They're probably underneath it. Like there's sawgrass growing in it for real. Dude, there's, oh my god, there's tadpoles in there, bro.
I seen them.
There's big old tadpoles, bro. Look, bullfrog tadpoles.
Bro, oh, there's a catfish in there, B.
No way.
Oh no, it is a tadpole. Oh, they were piping, dude, and they got done for.
Look at the eggs, dude. It's a lot of ants.
So big.
Yo, check this out right here. That's crazy.
That's super sketch, bro. Random house in the middle of nowhere. Gas station.
Do not feed the rednecks.
If black...
Red and yellow kill a fellow, right?
What?
If black touches yellow... I think it's a coral snake, bro. Black touches yellow, it kills a fellow. Black is touching yellow right there, bro.
There you go. I told you guys.
Most deadliest snake in Florida right there.
Do they like strike if you put your hand down?
I think he's hit. Why is he acting like that? Like king snake. Let me see his face. Hey there, buddy. What are you doing? That's crazy. Yeah, all those gar are stuck in there, y'all.
Yeah. Probably already dead.
I need to get to it, like, it's kind of smelling my life. Oh, it's like stuck.
Dang.
I can't even get to them. Oh, there's a turtle right there, too.
Oh, poor turtle. Save the turtles, hashtag. Oh, he's about to get swept in the current.
Saving Tucker, saving.
There he is. Go ahead, Tucker. Come on, buddy. We're just trying to save you.
Where'd he go?
Did he dive?
He dove.
Not even under the thing. I
know how to throw it.
I'm going to try to get those gar out of there. I'm going to take my boots off.
Yeah. Try to rescue them?
Yeah, they're alive. I saw them flipping.
Yeah, out. Yeah. They're still alive. They're just trapped, guys. We're going to try to rescue these gar right here.
See if I can get to them without busting my butt.
My
paint is going to get wet. Look, it's muddy. Hey, Sarah,
see if you can walk out on this mesh thing. Yeah.
There goes another one.
There you go. Beautiful, beautiful. Swim free, friend.
Look like they had a rough. Yeah, that's a dead one.
Unfortunately, some of these guys didn't make it. Got another one free. Sweet. Dang. Is he a goner?
That one's dead.
Oh no.
You can see like how tight. I'm fighting
in here, trying to get
him out. Fight that last thing that's on there.
That's crazy. Guys, these are the effects of humans, you know, setting up stuff, destroying the habitats. Unfortunately, these guys got to suffer for humans to be building stuff. And we do have two dead casualties right there. But thankfully, Tara was able to release all of them, get them free from that net.
It's a...
Decays
brown? What's the...
No,
what
it's
in the
a,
world?
What is it a garter
that?
Snake?
No, it's not. It's,
It's a ribbon snake? It looks like a decays brown, but it's got a weird head.
It does look a decays brown without the quotation marks behind its eye. It could be a very young...
Water
snake? No, decays brown snake.
Yeah, guys, if you guys know what type of snake this is, let us know in the comments. We know for a fact he's not venomous. You can tell just by the shape of his head. Doesn't have no venom glands present. So that's why we took a risk and tried grabbing him. But we think he can be a...
Decays brown snake.
Not 100% sure. But if you guys can help us identify, let us know in the comments down below. Oh, wow, look at that thing. Big, fat, invasive catfish. Got him in the bag.
Fucking python, bro. Whoa, scorpions, dude.
Oh my gosh. Are you kidding me?